J. Edgar Hoover.
Mr. President, I wish to depart briefly from the scheduled program for special recognition of this day. The most treasured possession of a special agent of the FBI is his gold badge with the American Eagle at the top. With it, he carries the motto of the FBI, fidelity, bravery, integrity. And therefore, it's with great pride and pleasure that I present this badge to you, and with it, you become an official member of the FBI family.
I want to express my appreciation, too, to Mr. Hoover for giving me an honorary membership in the FBI, and that allows me to tell a little story, which he would have told, I am sure, if he had not thought it might be perhaps a bit presumptuous. But he remembers, and I remember very well, that in 1937, I submitted an application to become a member of the FBI. And I never heard anything from that application. Now, years later, after I became Vice President of the United States, I asked Mr. Hoover what happened to my application. He did not know that I had submitted one. So he said, as he would always do, he said, I'll check the files. And sure enough, he found my application. And I don't know whether this part of the story is true or not, although Mr. Hoover always tells the truth. But nevertheless, he said that what had happened was that actually I had been approved as an agent of the FBI, except for one fact, that the Congress did not appropriate the necessary funds requested for the Bureau in the year 1937. And I just want to say in Mr. Hoover's presence and in Mr. Mitchell's presence, that will never happen again.
Mr. Nixon always, on several occasions, described himself to me as an intellectual. Called himself at one point the egghead of the Republican Party, and he compared himself on occasion to Adlai Stevenson.
Everybody has a hobby in this great house. Mine is not reading westerns or looking at television. We've removed some of the television sets. I do look. Although they have the Colts and the Rams on tomorrow, I'll look at that. But nevertheless, but it is reading, and particularly reading in the field of history.
He told me one time that he'd rather be teaching in some school like Oxford, he said, and writing two or three books a year.
Nixon, so long, yes, Nixon.